It's barely 2 hours to go before Melbourne returns to a lockdown for 6 weeks. Authorities have reimposed restrictions after seeing a spike in COVID-19 infections. People have gone on a spree of panic buying ahead of the shutdown. ABC News reporter Bridget Rollison with more.
Welcome to Lockdown City.
It won't be an absolute ring of steel, but there's going to be a significant police presence.
From midnight tonight, a hard border will be in place around Greater Melbourne and the Mitchell Shire, and hundreds of police, along with the army, will be cracking down.
If you don't have a reason to leave, you'll be turned back around. If someone breaches those guidelines and leaves when they shouldn't, you'll receive an infringement, $1,652.
But business owners are counting their dollars. Some have only just reopened their doors.
For the business, obviously, having to shut the doors, it is a big hit financially.
We are on JobKeeper. We've taken on some staff, and I think, you know, based on where we are at the moment, we might have to stand them down again.
Once again, supermarkets are working to keep up stock levels by limiting product purchases. Victoria now has 860 active cases. Nearly 300 of those are in the Hume and Wyndham areas. There are more than 100 in the city, while there are now no active cases in the Mornington Peninsula, but it's still included in the lockdown.
We're all Victorians now, because we're all Australians, and that's where the challenge is right now.
75 cases have now been recorded inside Melbourne's lockdown public housing flats, but there is some good news. Testing of all 3,000 residents is expected to finish tonight. Once those results are analysed, residents can return to the same restrictions as the rest of Melbourne.
You will be under these restrictions for not a moment longer than you need to be.
Meanwhile, the Altaqua school outbreak has now exceeded 100 cases, and around 2,000 students and their families are having to isolate.
Schools were a massive headache for the government last time, and once again loom as another big problem. The Premier said today a return to remote learning for prep to year 10 is more likely than not next term for Melbourne students, the news millions of parents will be dreading.